Had a lot of history of agriculture in the Columbia Basin. We also have a long history of wildfire. In some cases, both of those have resulted in a shift and a transition in the landscape. My name is Curtis Bryan. I'm the field manager for the Wenatchee Field Office in Wenatchee, Washington, right in the heart of the Columbia Basin. A lot of the lands that BLM manages in the Central Columbia Basin have some kind of an altered state for one reason or another. The science supports that the plant communities, the soil conditions, are not what they could be.
My name is Chris Sheridan. I'm the Restoration Program Coordinator for the Spokane District. Since 2003, the BLM in Spokane District has performed science-based restoration in the Columbia Plateau shrub-steppe to meet our regulatory requirements for rangeland health, to support sensitive species, and to reduce fuel loads in these habitats. This effort has occurred in some of the most complex and difficult habitat in the shrub-steppe environment, sites with very low resistance to invasion and low resilience to disturbance. The geological context for the Columbia Plateau includes hundreds of feet of volcanic basalt cut down through by the Missoula floods, creating coulees such as Moses Coulee that we stand in, and then overlaying that with some wind-blown luss, providing thin soil and variable soil throughout the Columbia Plateau treatment areas.
Our goal with that restoration program is to look for ways to try to bring those communities back into line with what the historic reference plant community might be.
Using restoration science, Spokane District has restored over 2,000 acres of shrub-steppe habitat in the Columbia Plateau of Washington. We use this plot and plots like it to describe the conditions before we go out and potentially do a restoration, and then after, and we're able to determine that this area was departed from its reference conditions. It had higher levels of non-native species, so that was our clue that we were going to have to potentially do some work here.
It's a complex landscape, and so partnerships are absolutely essential and critical to being able to succeed on a landscape level.
The Spokane District has been working on our seed program, which is a key part of post-disturbance restoration, for almost 20 years. During that time period, we've worked with a number of vendors and partners to develop seed genotypes that are adapted to the sites so that folks can respond immediately following disturbance and not have to do all this work again from scratch.
We are at the BFI Native Seeds Cleaning Facility in Warden, Washington. We bring in the raw seed from the fields, and then it goes through all these screens and air systems that separates the seed and the chaff, and you end up with a finished, clean, high-quality product to then be bagged and ready to go out to restoration projects. In a few years, you've got quality native habitat back on the ground.
We are at a sandberg bluegrass field here that is a native biotype from north-central Washington. It will be used extensively throughout north-central Washington in native habitat restoration. I have what's called a swather. I'll fire this up and we'll see what we can do. And we're going to do a little demonstration of the combining process of harvesting the native grass seed. It does an amazingly good job of extracting the seed from the stems and chaff.
We grow for BLM all over the West, but we grow for Forest Service, Nature Conservancy, U.S. Fish and Wildlife Service. We grow for lots of different entities, and we try to have available the species and the biotypes that are very specific to their project locations.
It's important to understand that you don't have to be an expert in everything. You can't be the expert in everything. You've got a really deep pool of talented people out there that you can tap into to make good, sound decisions that are based on science.
This is one of the Spokane District's first restoration sites. This one was first treated in 2003, and it's a really great example of what science-based management can actually accomplish. The majority of this site was seeded with four native grass species. Those were hugely successful.
A lot of the management decisions we make, the success is measured over a long period of time, you know, decades in some cases. And this is one of those programs where you can work with your collaborators and work with your partners, develop a plan, implement the plan, and within a few years, see the success that you anticipated.
There's always extremely complex factors that are going on between climate, competing species, grazing, and others. Restoration science in shrub-steppe and in ecology in general needs to be seen as a combination of art and science that's always evolving.
It has the benefits for wildlife habitat. It has benefits for livestock producers out on the landscape. It has benefits to our recreation users out on the landscape.
It's a point of pride to actually have functioning habitat, habitat that looks good for the public.
It's one of those programs that everybody can get behind, and that's, I think, what makes it so successful.